Just to update that, not too long ago, hearing the White House daily briefing, they were asked about plans for appointing a czar. And so far, the spokesperson saying no plans as of right now, that they have full confidence in the director of the CDC, that the president of the United States does. But what about a surgeon general? Shouldn't he be in charge, or she? Here to talk about that column is Michael Hiltzik, who wrote about this very issue in the LA Times and A.B. Stoddard, associate editor of The Hill. Welcome to both of you. And Michael, let me just begin with you, because I heard about your piece, days ago, and I wanted to talk to you because you make this point. I don't know how many Americans are aware. There is no surgeon general. This would be the point person, and you say there is one very specific group to blame for that.
That's right. It's the National Rifle Association. We know that President Obama nominated a surgeon general back in November. That was to succeed the previous surgeon general who had resigned in mid-year. He was Dr. Vivek Murthy of Harvard. He was nominated in November, and in February, the NRA dug up a number of statements he had made, basically expressing the viewpoint that gun control was a public health issue. They found that unacceptable. They wrote letters to Senator Harry Reid, Senator Mitch McConnell, and they said Dr. Murthy is not acceptable to them, and that basically quashed his nomination really up to today. So we don't have a surgeon general.
So because, A.B. Stoddard, we do not have a surgeon general, if one existed, what would one be doing about all of this Ebola right now? Would there be a big difference?
Well, that's a very interesting question, because you heard at the briefing today Josh Earnest say that Lisa Monaco, who is the Homeland Security Advisor to President Obama, is coordinating the response but is not in charge. The publication The Federalist just reported yesterday there is actually someone who has this job. She is an assistant secretary at the Health and Human Services Department. Her name is Dr. Nicole Lurie, and she is the assistant secretary for preparedness and response for public health emergencies. She's nowhere to be found. And at the same time, President Obama, we know, has the attention of the world right now. He could come and say Congress is preventing the confirmation of Dr. Murthy, but he's not doing it because there are Democrats running for re-election in southern states and places where the NRA matters. So what I think ultimately for President Obama, this is bad because the public will blame him no matter what. Even if he gets rid of the CDC director, Dr. Frieden, the public is going to blame the administration for the Ebola response.
Let me just stay with you, A.B., on the issue of politics. We also know, there are conservatives who are calling for the chief of the CDC, Dr. Tom Frieden, to resign. And when you look, though, at what's happened with Veterans Affairs, when you look at what's happened with Secret Service, do resignations really ever solve anything?
No, and it would be difficult, as I said, for at this point, you look at a lot of nominations of this administration are stalled, and they can't even replace the attorney general right now because the politics are so toxic, trying to get somebody else through. And so at this point, even if they wanted Dr. Frieden to step down, who would they choose? What would the scrutiny of that person be? And at this point, the blame game is probably a waste of time. And so I think you'll see the administration continue. Like they said, they have confidence in him to resist any kind of effort to replace him.
That's what we just heard within this past hour, full confidence in Dr. Frieden. Michael, 30 seconds, your final thoughts on all of this.
Well, look, I think the point about the Surgeon General is that the Surgeon General of the United States is the public face of public health. Whoever that is wouldn't be in charge of this effort, but would be out there calming the American public, putting all this in perspective. That's very important in this particular incident. That's what we're not getting. We're not getting any perspective on how important Ebola is or what other public health issues really need to be addressed. That's really what we're lacking and what we should have.